सदाशिवसमारंभां शंकराचार्यमध्यमास्मदाचार्यपर्यंतां वंदे गुरुपरंपरां श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। यो ब्रह्माणि जाति पूर्व वेदागश्च प्रहिणोति तस्मै तगुम्हदेवमात्मबुद्धिप्रकाशं मुमुक्षुर्वै शरणमहं प्रपद्ये। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। आम्नायन्ते संसिद्धम् आदिमध्यान्तवर्जितम् आनन्दघनम् आपूर्णम् आत्मज्योतिरुपास्महे। सो वी सॉ स्मरन्ति च एंड सिमिलर इज दी स्मृति टू एस्टैब्लिश दैट आसीनः एव उपासनम् कर्तव्यम्। So this is what we saw in the last part. Now further, पूर्वम् अंग अनाश्रित उपासनेषु यथा आसन नियमः उक्तः। That उपासनास which are not dependent on the कर्मांग, for them आसन नियमः was stated that it should be these उपासनास should be done in a sitting position in समासन। तद्वद् दिगादि नियमः अपि अस्तु। इन द एंड वी सॉ सुचौ देशे प्रतिष्ठाप्य इत्यादि वाज कोटेड इन द वृत्ति बाय द सिद्धांती। सो पूर्व पक्षी सेज लेट देयर बी देश काल नियम ऑल्सो जस्ट लाइक इट इज देयर फॉर कर्म। सो फॉर दीज उपासनास विच आर इंडिपेंडेंट फॉर देम ऑल्सो लेट देयर बी दिगादि नियम रूल्स रिगार्डिंग विच direction to face and what time should the upasana be done etc. All these niyamas let them apply even to the independent upasana, says the Purvapakshi. To that he quotes, to that effect he quotes prachina pravane vaishya devena yajeta ityadi digadi niyama darshanad iti drishtanta sangatya idamah. Because there is a shruti vakya prachina pravane वैश्व देवेन यजेत। सो वैश्व देवेन सो वैश्व देव याग शुड बी डन प्राचीन प्रवणे। सो प्राचीन प्रवण इज वेर इन दी प्राचीन दिक् इन दी ईस्टर्न डायरेक्शन। प्रवण प्रवण इज देर इज अ स्लोप सो निम्न भूमि। सो वेर द ग्राउंड स्लोप्स टुवर्ड्स द ईस्ट दैट इज सेट टू बी अ गुड प्लेस टू डू वैश्वदेव इत्यादि वैश्वदेव। सो इत्यादि मीनिंग देर आर सच सिमिलर श्रुति वाक्यास और शास्त्र वाक्यास वेर दिगादि नियमस आर सीन। सो देर बाय द नियम रूल्स विच वेर मेंशनड मीनिंग डिफरेंट सेट ऑफ रूल्स वेर मेंशनड एज टू आसना सम आसना इज नीडेड टू फॉलो उपासनास। Similarly, other rules also should be followed, says the Purvapakshi. So he is extending the logic there. Therefore, it's a drishtanta sangati. Thereby, we have ekagrata adhikaranam. So ekagrata adhikaranam has the first sutra as yatra ekagrata tatra visheshat. Yatra ekagrata tatra visheshat. Siddhanti says that yatra ekagrata tatra avisheshat. So wherever there is ekagrata, in whichever deshakala, deshadi, digadi, there is ekagrata, there is concentration possible, because at many places concentration is not possible, where there is a lot of noise or you don't feel, you know, there's some feel of energy, you know, you feel some kind of, you go to a particular place, you become depressed. So there, the concentration is not possible, ekagrata, the mind cannot be focused in the tattva, in the upasya vishaya. Therefore, such places should be avoided. There is no particular mention of a place or डायरेक्शन बट यत्र एकाग्रता भवति वेर एवर देर इज सिंगल पॉइंटेड अटेंशन पॉसिबल कॉन्सेंट्रेशन ऑफ द माइंड देर इटसेल्फ वन कैन डू उपासना देर इज नो अदर विशेषा देर फॉर अविशेषात देर इज नो पर्टिक्युलर मेन्शन इन दि श्रुति रिगार्डिंग इंडिपेंडेंट उपासनास अत्र पूर्वपक्षे दिगादिषु आदरः सिद्धान्ते तु अनादरः इति फलभेदः पूर्वपक्षी सेज दैट दिगादि नियम विच इज एप्लीकेबल इन द केस ऑफ कर्म और तदाश्रित उपासनास इज एप्लीकेबल इवन टू द इंडिपेंडेंट उपासना सिद्धांति डिसएग्रीज एज टू सच नियमास बीइंग देयर एज टू सच नियमास बीइंग देयर तेषु एव उपासनेषु दिगादि नियम अस्ति न वा इति विषये अस्ति इति पूर्वपक्ष सो इट इज अ एक्सटेंशन ऑफ दैट एज टू पूर्वपक्षी सेज दैट देयर इज दिगादि नियम टू बी फॉलोड बाय उपासकास हू आर डूइंग इंडिपेंडेंट उपासनास ऑल्सो सिद्धांतस्तु प्राच्यादि दिगादि नियमो नास्ति दि रूल रिगार्डिंग फेसिंग द ईस्ट फॉर आचमना इत्यादि और फॉर सम कर्म सच रूल्स आर नॉट एप्लीकेबल इन द केस ऑफ इंडिपेंडेंट उपासनास टू दैट द सिद्धांति रेजेस एन ऑब्जेक्शन एंड सेज ननु समे शुचौ इति देश विशेष श्रूयते इति चेत बाढ़म तिलिति चेत इज पूर्वपक्ष सिद्धांति सेज बाढ़म सो ननु समे शुचौ इति देश विशेष सो सम काइंड ऑफ नियम इज सीन as to wherever there is saucha cleanliness so and there is a level also leveling samay shuchau so this is a simple meaning there iti desha vishesha shruyate at least that much you have to agree as to it should be a clean place and a leveled ground you know you can't sit on a in an asana in a particular place and then slide down So at least such rule should be followed. Shruyate iti chet. Such desha vishesha is there. Some kind of a place is mentioned in Shruti. Siddhanti says badam. Badam means it can be, badam is generally used to agree or to agree with a part of what he is saying. तरपि श्रवणं चित्तस्य एकाग्रता संपादक देशे उपासीते इति दर्शयति सिद्धांति सेज या दैट मच आई एग्री विथ बट लुक एट व्हाट इज द तात्पर्य देयर सो दैट द माइंड गेट्स फोकस्ड एकाग्रता शुड बी पॉसिबल देयरफॉर इट सेज दैट द प्लेस शुड बी क्लीन इफ द प्लेस इज स्टिंकिंग देन ऑब्वियसली देयर कैन नॉट बी एकाग्रता The Durgandha will keep the mind distracted. And obviously, if the place is not leveled enough, then the body cannot be steady. And if the body is not steady, how can you have single pointed mind? Therefore, Tadapi, that Same Shuchau Ityadi Shruti also, is for what purpose? Tadapi Shravanam, Chittasya Ekagrata, Sampadaka Deshe Upasite Iti Darshayati. It shows that. You meditate in such a place, you do upasana in such a place where the mind can get concentrated. That's all the tatparya is in even such shrutis. Vakyasheshe manonukulatva visheshanat. Why? Because in Vakyashesha, if you go further, you see manonukule natu chakshu pidane. So where? So samashucho, but if you go further, there is mano anukulatva. So manasa anukulatvam is mentioned there. The mind should be benefited by the place. Meaning the mind should not be distracted by the surroundings. That is the Vakyashesha even in the Shruti that you have quoted, says the Siddhanti. Then what about this Prachina Pravana Ityadi which was quoted? To that Siddhanti says Prachina Pravane Ityadi Shravanam tu Karmanyeva no Upasaneshu iti Drashtavyam. That is applicable as to Vaishvadeva Yaga should be done in a particular place where the in the eastern side where there is a sloping ground. So that is the Vishesha applicable only to those rules are applicable only to Vaishvadeva and such similar Yagas Karma Kanda where Karma is being done here these Upasanas are independent they are not. Dependent on the karma, they are not based they do not have foundation in the karma, based on the karma, or they don't have foundation in the karma. Therefore, these rules are not applicable for upasanas. Iti drashtavyam. This is how you have to understand, says the Siddhanti. This is also single sutra adhikarana. The next adhikarana is aprayana adhikaranam. The 8th adhikarana begins with the 12th sutra, to which the introduction goes as purvam yatha digadi niyama ashravanat. Niyamasya or niyamanam ashravanat. Tada bhava uktaha. Purvam meaning in the earlier adhikarana, where the upasanas that are independent were discussed, there digadi niyama, the rules based on direction, etc., desha kala ityadi niyama, were shown to be not applicable because there is no such shruti. Shruti does not ordain it, so we need not do some swakapola kalpana. We need not think ahead and say, okay, these are the rules which I am going to extend. There is no such practice at all in karmakandis also, where shruti does not say something and they do. It is not true. Therefore, these niyamas, rules which were mentioned with respect to karmakanda, should not be extended to independent upasanas. Even if you extend it to dependent upasanas, karmanga ashrita upasanas, they should not be extended to karmanga anashrita upasanas. Tatha, similarly says the Purvapakshi, and he brings up an exemplified, thereby Drishtanta Sangati saying, Tatha yavajyam upasana avrutti ashravanat. In Karmakanda, they keep on quoting Yavat Jiva Shruti. Yavat Jivam Agnihotram Juhiyat. Therefore, as long as one is alive, one cannot give up karma. One has to do Agnihotradi karma. Grihastha cannot take sannyasa or vanaprastha. Vanaprastha also, when he takes vanaprastha, when he goes to the forest also, still the Agnihotradi should not be given up, says the Purvapakshi. He has been saying this through and through at every opportune moment. However, now he says this Yavajjiva Shruti is applicable to Agnihotradi karma, but it is not applicable to the independent upasanas, because there is no Shruti. Just like Digadi Niyama Shruti is not there in the case of independent upasanas, similarly Yavajjiva Shruti is also not there in the case of independent upasanas, karmanga anashrita upasanas. Therefore, what should be the resultant conclusion that the Siddhanti also should make, is that upasanas should not be done till the last moment of life, meaning amrutehe aprayanat. Amrutehe amaranat, meaning as long as one is alive, one should do the upasana as per the Siddhanta perspective is invalidated by the same process that Siddhanti has used as per the Purvapakshi. So he says, Tatha yavajyam upasana avrutti, meaning abhyasa upasana that you insisted. Because this all this started with the Purvapakshi saying that upasana or shravanadi, basically upasana and then shravanadi also, we should take both simultaneously, because one is for krama mukti, other is for jivan mukti. So if Jivan Mukti is being discussed, the objections which are discussed, they may be, as long as there is no clear perspective and a strict mention and which cannot be extended logically, we should extend it to upasanas also, meaning independent upasanas that will give Brahmaloka Gati and Krama Mukti, Ahangra Upasana Ityadi. And flip side also, if it is an objection regarding the Ahangra or Brahmaloka Prapti upasanas, independent upasanas, which can give separate phala also, of course, but we should see whether such objection would be logically extended to Jnana Kanda proper also, meaning Shuddha Jnana Kanda or Jivan Mukti case also, Jnana. There also we should read the objection and try to understand. Because as we saw at the opening of the chapter also, and earlier as well, both of these go hand in hand. Upasana and Jnana, because for whom Jnana is not possible because of Buddhimandya, there Shruti gives an option out in the form of Brahmaloka Prapti and thereby Krama Mukti, So upasana is to be followed, and we see this across Upanishads. In Taittiriya also there are upasanas. Across vallis there are upasanas. In all three vallis there are upasanas, and sometimes upasana follows the jnana also, meaning when the Aikya Vakya or Mahavakya is given such upadesha, even after that there is some discussion on upasanas, because Shruti knows that Uttama Adhikaris are missing and there are a lot of Adhama and Madhyama Adhikaris, so upasana has to be done, otherwise it is difficult to get sthirata in jnana even if jnanotpatti takes place. Holding on to jnana is extremely difficult, definitely because of obstacles, but they can be countered by upasana. Karma and upasana, but karma is also assumed in the earlier sadhana. But upasana is lacking for most of us. Even if we do some basic karma like sandhya ityadi, upasanas are lacking. Therefore, ekagrata is also lacking, and jnanotpatti may take place, or it appears that jnana has taken place. However, it does not stay. This is what we think. Most of us have this anubhava. Thereby, Shruti gives us option. Even in Kena, we see Upanishadam bho bruhi, says the Shishya after the Upanishad Mahavakya has been taught. Mahavakya, in a sense, wherever there is Jiva, Brahma, Aikya discussed. Even after that, somebody says, please teach Upanishad. To that, the Bhashya says that, Bhagavan Bhashyakara says that, it is not that the Shishya has not understood, but he is asking, is there anything more? Or you say that Upanishad is done. He knows that Upanishad is taught, but he wants to know, is there something more? Or he gives, meaning Bhagavan Bhashyakara gives some concession to the Shishya as to why he asked. Is it dull? Is he a dullard? So to that, Bhagavan Bhashyakara gives some concession and says, no, that is not the idea there. He wants to know if there is something more beyond this. So the teacher answers as to there is nothing more there, but if you have to do something more, if you feel, then you do. So he reads that jnana has not taken place, therefore you do some upasana. So upasana is taught there, where in the form of an akhyayika and so on. So you understand this Uma, who taught that this Yaksha was Brahma. If you recollect the context, if you have seen it, then you'll know as to the Upanishad opening akhyayika is extended there as to who was this Yaksha. To that, Uma had appeared and given the response to Indra as to that was Paramatma himself. Brahma Tattva himself manifests there to teach them a lesson that all their wins were due to Ishwara, not due to themselves, meaning it was not the win of Devatas without the Paramatma Tattva, Brahma Tattva. So all the wins are due to Satta, Spurti, everything is due to Brahma Tattva. Then taking that into account, that Yaksha who came for a moment, who appeared for a moment, manifested for a moment and then disappeared, that kind of upasana is taught with Vidyut Ityadi. So that is the context there. The focus is to in these upasanas which are to be done, whether it is for Krama Mukti or which will lead to Ekagrata and Chitta Shuddhi also, whereby this subtle tattva can be understood in Jnanakanda proper. Therefore, objections and answers thereto may be applicable to both upasanas and jnana. That is the tatparya whereby I brought this up. So, iti drishtanta sangatya idamaha. As to whether the jnana avrutti or upasana avrutti abhyasa should be done till the end of life by the sadhaka or not. As long as one is alive, that is all one should do. Says the siddhanta. However, in shravana, shravanam punah punah kuryat, amrutehe kuryat, asuptehe amrutehe. Elsewhere we see this. Asuptehe amrutehe kalam nayet vedanta chintanaya. Chintanena va. Chintaya or chintanena. आई थिंक इट इज चिंतया. सो कालम नयेत वेदांत चिंतया. हाउ लॉन्ग शुड वन डू वेदांत चिंता? आसुप्ते है आमृते है. एज लॉन्ग एज वन इज नॉट अस्लीप मीनिंग ऑल द वेकिंग आवर्स एंड एज लॉन्ग एज वन इज अलाइव मीनिंग ऑल द वेकिंग आवर्स टिल द एंड ऑफ द लाइफ. दिस इज द बिकॉज देर इज नथिंग एल्स टू डू. एंड देर ऑल्सो इट इज सेड दैट इन दैट वेरी श्लोका. सो आसुप्ते है आमृते है एंड देन कालम नयेत. वाई? बिकॉज फॉर काम किंचिदपि आई डोंट रिकॉल दी वर्स देर बट देन वन शुड नॉट दध्यान्नावसरम किंचित कामादीना मनागपि आसुप्तेर आमृते कालम नयेत वेदांत चिंतया. वाई शुड वन डू दैट? बिकॉज किंचिदपि कामादीनां मनागपि मनागपि नॉट इवन ए लिटिल वन शुड गिव अवसर न दद्यात् अवसरम कामादीनाम अवसरम न दद्यात् किंचित् मनागपि. दिस इज दी श्लोका वी सी एल्सवेयर विच इज प्रिटी गुड टू रिकलेक्ट एंड फॉलो एज मच एज पॉसिबल. देर बाय दिस आप्रायणाधिकरण हैज कम अप वेयर पूर्व पक्षी ऑब्जेक्ट एज टू यावत् जीव उपासना आवृत्ति श्रवण has not taken place, meaning there is no shruti which says that upasana should be done as long as one is alive or jnana avritti should be followed. Why do you follow brahmakar avritti till the person sadhaka is alive? Why should he do it? So you apply the same rule as you did for niyamas regarding independent upasanas. You apply yavat jiva shruti also being applicable only to karma, not to upasanas. टू दैट भगवान भगवान सूत्रकार से आप्रायाण तत्रापि दृष्टम आप्रायाण तत्रापि दृष्टम. सो आ प्रायाणात तत्र अपि ही दृष्टम. सिद्धांति से इज दैट आप्रायाणात आसमंतात प्रायाणात इज मरणात आ मरणात टिल एंड ऑफ लाइफ उपासित तत्र अपि ही दृष्टम. इट इज सीन सो मीनिंग विल शो यू हाउ इट इज सीन विल सीन दी वृत्ति एज टू वॉट इज ए श्रुति दैट सेज आप्रायणात तत्र विद रिस्पेक्ट टू दैट ऑल्सो अपि ही इंडीड इट इज सीन और बिकॉज ही यतः यस्मात् कारणात् दृष्टम श्रुतिरस्ति एव श्रवणात. दैट इज द आइडिया हियर. सिद्धांति रिस्पॉन्ड्स सेइंग दैट देर इज अ श्रुति. अत्र पूर्वपक्षे कजा का दिस शुड बी कादाचित का देर इज अ टाइपो देर. अत्र पूर्वपक्षे कादाचित् प्रत्यावृत्तेः अदृष्टद्वारा उपास्य साक्षात्कार हेतुत्वम्. सो पूर्वपक्षी सेज कादाचित् प्रत्यावृत्तेः सम प्रत्यय सम ब्रह्माकार वृत्ति और सम उपासना वृत्ति विल गिव अदृष्ट मीनिंग सम टाइम यू आर डूइंग उपासनास दैट विल गिव अदृष्ट. What he has stated earlier as to a single shravanadi or single upasana will give adrushta, that is sufficient. So pratya avrutti if you do, then one of these will lead to adrushta. Some pratya, some vritti will lead to adrushta. And adrushta dwara, through this adrushta, that result which will be held to give the final result. So this is like a stepping stone result that adrushta dwara. उपास्य साक्षात्कार हेतुत्व देन उपास्य साक्षात्कार विल टेक प्लेस एट सम पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम. अदृष्टा विल बी देर इट कैन बी देन एंड देर इट सेल्फ. अदृष्टा हैज कम अप एंड इट विल फ्रक्टिफाई देन और इट विल फ्रक्टिफाई लेटर एंड उपास्य विषय देवता साक्षात्कार विल टेक प्लेस ड्यू टू दिस प्रत्यावृत्ति विच इज कादाचित का वी डोंट नो विच वन. सो वन ऑफ दिस विल गिव यू नॉट continuously holding the upasana vritti or jnana vritti that will not give but some single pratyavritti or single vritti also may lead there or you can say avritti also if you do there. Kadachit meaning at some point of time it may give you a result through the adrishta. So this is the Purvapakshi's view. Siddhante nirantara pratyavruttehe sakshadeva tadhetuttvam iti phalabhedaha. So nirantara pratyavrutti. Siddhanti says, no, it is not that once in a while you do some upasana and that will, you know, you did upasana today, you and then after some time you did another upasana, then the same upasana you did another time. So one of these upasanas or the same upasanas done some point of time may give you a result via adrushta. Siddhanti says it is not so. Nirantara pratyavrutti should be done. Meaning, it is like dhyana. As stated earlier, it is like dhyana. It is not that you do some vritti and then you have another vritti, something else. You do all worldly activities and then do another upasana some point of time. It is not so. It won't work. It has to be a continuous upasana. Nirantara pratyavrutti. In dhyana, it cannot be that, okay, I did 2 minutes, 5 minutes, whatever. It should be continuous. Nirantara pratyavrutti should be there. Brahmakara vritti also should be nirantara. Sakshareva tadhetuttvam. Tasya avruttehe. This nididhyasana, when jnana has taken place or when jnana hasn't taken place, that time dhyana, upasana, ahangra or such kind of upasana, nirguna brahma upasana, sakshadeva tadhetuttvam. That has sakshat hetu. It is a sakshat hetu, so it has sakshat hetuttvam. Iti phalabheda, this is the difference. That continuous brahmakara vritti or continuous upasana alone will give result. It is not that some upasana at some point of time will give result via adrushta. Atra ahangra upasanani kim kadachit krutva uparamet. Uta yavajyam upasita iti vishaye kadachid iti purva pakshaha. So sometimes you can keep on doing upasanas whenever possible. Is that the case? With regards to ahangra upasana. I am this mukhya prana which is non-different from Brahma, or I am non-different from Brahma. That kind of an upasana, should it be done kadachit, at, you know, whenever possible. And then you take a pause. You take some days off and then you continue with, or you take some hours off and then again try this upasana for a few minutes. It is not so. Uta yavat jivam. So yavat jivam. So kadachit means one can say, you know, we come across people who say, oh, I used to do this earlier, I stopped. Will that work? Siddhanti say it won't. Yavat jivam upasite iti vishaye kadachiditi purvapaksha. Siddhanti say siddhantastu aprayanat amaranat upasita. The upasana should be done till the end of life. Specifically, this is applicable for upasanas because Brahmaloka Prapti, we see, whether it is in Taittiriya Upanishad or elsewhere, we see in Chandogya Ityadi, how the upasaka should leave the body. There is a niyama. He has to accumulate the prana and he should launch himself from the Hridayakasha. So, Taittiriya mantra, I am unable to recall exact words, but Vyapohya, Shirsha Kapale, I think, Vyapohya Shirsha Kapale. So, from Brahmarandra, the Jiva leaves. That is, what does it mean by Jiva leaves? The Jiva should make a choice how to leave the body. That choice is there only for an Upasaka. Others do not even know when they are going to die. The Upasaka knows when the time is there and then he should sit in a particular asana. He should do the Upasana the way he was doing and then he should leave the body from the Shushumna, Shushumna Nadi, which opens up in the Brahmarandra. And then, in fact, there are some Upasakas we hear as to, there is a physical crack of the skull heard. And you see that in Brahmarandra there is a hole also. There have been cases where these have been seen. So it is not something that we think that is hearsay. It is a Shruti which is Pramana, and those who have followed, they know, we see them as examples also. He is Yataha Yasmat Karana Tatrapi. Tatrapi means Marana Kale Api यावत् क्रतुर अयम अस्मान् लोकात् प्रैति इति श्रुत्या उपास्य प्रत्यानुवर्तनं दृष्टम्। सो यावत् क्रतुः अयम अस्मान् लोकात् प्रैति, सो यू सी सच श्रुति आल्सो एज टू नियम, गिविंग अ नियम मीनिंग यावत् क्रतुः, द वे दि संकल्प हैज बीन डन, ही गिव्स अस्मान् लोकात्, अस्मान् लोकात् अस्मान् शरीरात्, और फ्रॉम दिस लोका ही लीव्स, मीनिंग लीविंग दिस बॉडी ही गोज टू अनदर लोका, देयरफॉर अस्मान् लोकात् अस्मान् शरीरात् अपि प्रैति ही ट्रेवल्स इति श्रुत्या उपास्य प्रत्यय अनुवर्तनम दृष्टम। एंड दिस इज नॉट इन दी कर्मकांड, इट इज इन दी उपासना कांड, एंड एज आई कोटेड दिस तैतिरीय श्रुति ऑल्सो, देयर ऑल्सो यू हियर दिस। सो उपास्य प्रत्यय अनुवर्तनम दृष्टम, यू सी दैट इट इज एट द मरण काल वेर द उपासक इज सेट टू बी डूइंग उपासना एंड ही लीव्स, देयरफॉर आमरणात अप टू मरणा वन हैज टू, मरण काल वन हैज टू डू उपासना, न च तद अदृष्ट साध्यम। व्हाट अबाउट दिस अदृष्ट द्वारा उपास्य साक्षात्कार हेतुत्वम, टू दैट सिद्धांति सेज नो, देयर इज नथिंग फॉर अदृष्टा टू डू देयर। Why should adrushta not be considered there? Ask the Purvapakshi to that Siddhanti. Drushte sambhavati adrushta kalpanan upapatti. Hey, this is a niyama. This is a mimamsaka niyama, mimamsa niyama, that drushte sambhavati sati. Wherever drushta phala is possible, there adrushta kalpana anupapatti. Adrushta kalpana gaurava is there. You should not do adrushta kalpana. Adrushta is applicable only when drushta phala is not there. Swargaloka is said to be phala for the karma kandi, for some karma. So somebody who is doing jyotishtoma ityadi, swarga is the phala. Is the swarga phala drishta? Immediate no. Then you have to do adrishta kalpana there. Because drishta phala is not there, swarga is not drishta to you, it is not given immediately after the yaga. You don't even know what swarga is other than Shruti's description. Therefore, you have to imagine adrushta. This is what the Mimamsa does. Mimamsakas do this, that do this kalpana. They imagine adrushta to be accumulated, which accrues to the yajmana, and then at the opportune moment, right moment, when it is ready to fructify, it will yield its result in the form of swargaloka. Tasmad amaranam ahangra upasanam kurvita iti siddham. Tasmad meaning what? Since drushtaphala is there, adrushtakalpana is invalidated, is not to be done. You should not imagine some adrushta, therefore it is not adrushta sadhya. If it is not adrushta sadhya, drushtam in Shruti, what is seen, that will be possible at the maranakala only for the upasaka. Therefore, upasana should be continued till the end of life. Tasmad amaranam ahangra upasanam kurvita. So ahangra upasana you should do till end of life, because that last moment itself will be the final cause for leading to Brahmaloka. If one does not do the upasana at the end moment, then whatever vritti is there, that kind of janma one may get, as it is seen in Gita also, marana kale. But this niyama is not applicable for the jnani, so we should see the objection as being applicable in such case, but the answer may not be valid. However, as we saw that shravana also should be done even after jnanotpatti, one can do shravana. There is no niyama that one should do, but one can do, and one should do because there is nothing else to do, and also for jnana rakshana and videha mukti. Till Videha Mukti, the Jivan Mukti, Ananda Prapti also, to hold on to the Ananda Vritti, if the Prarabdha is troubling. Purva yatha upasakanam yavajyam kartavyam asti tyuktam na tatha brahmatma vidam iti pratyudarana sangatya karma kshaya lakshanam Jivan Muktim aha. So Siddhanti says that for upasaka there is yavajiva kartavyata in upasanas. For upasaka there is a niyama, because one has to launch oneself from the upasana itself. One has to leave the body. Praiti has been mentioned. Na tatha brahmatma vidam. For those who are jnanis, mukhya, in the mukhya sense, not in the upasakas, but those who have had aikya jnana, and thereby they have become jnanis, na tatha. They do not have this yavat jiva niyama. As long as one is alive, one should not do, one need not do, or one should do. That kind of a niyama is not there. Iti pratyudharana sangha. This is a counter example to it. And thereby, karmakshaya lakshanam jivan mukti maha. Why so? Because karmakshaya takes place, the karma ceases to bind the jnani after jnanutpatti. Jnanagni bhasmasat kurute. Karmani. All the karmas are burned except for prarabdha. So this karma is going to be discussed in the next adhikarana, which is tad adhigama adhikaranam, in which the first sutra is tad adhigama uttara purvaghayor ashlesha vinashau tad vyapadeshat. Tad adhigama uttara purvaghayor ashlesha vinashau tad vyapadeshat. That's a sutra. Tad adhigama ha. Tadadigama tasya adigamaha shashti tat purusha. It's a samasa. So tad not tadadigama tadadigame. So this is saptami. Tadadigame sati. Tadadigame sati. Not tadadigamaha tadadigame uttara purva aghayoho. So uttara purva, uttara is later. Purva is before. Before what? Jnana. So after jnana and before jnana. Agha. Agha is papa. So the papa, set of papas which are prior to jnana, jnanotpatti, and those papas which are done by the sharira, jnani sharira, after the jnanotpatti, tayoho ashlesha vinashau. Tayoho ashlesha vinashau. So ashlesha and vinasha. So these should be read respectively with uttara and purva. So uttara agha and purva agha is a dvandva samasa there. And then ashlesha and vinasha will also go with uttara agha and purva agha respectively. How is that? So uttara, which are done later, there is ashlesha. Ashlesha is no sambandha. Jnani has no sambandha with the papa which is done by the body, which gets done. He does not do papa, but some papa may get done, hurting someone else unintentionally. Someone may get hurt. So uttara agha papa has ashlesha, meaning jnani has no sambandha. So or rather, the papa does not bind the jnani, therefore papa does not have sambandha with the jnani. Whereas purva agha, purva papa, all the papa which is accumulated in sanchita, this uttara is agami. So agami papa has no sambandha with the jnani, but the purva sanchita papa has vinasha, which had sambandha with the jnani, because jnani was a jiva then, ajnani. When he was an ajnani, that time he considered himself as a jiva who had done sanchita papa. So sanchita aga, purva aga, so there was connection that is snapped. So it is cut off. There is vinasha, complete nasha of sanchita papa. So sanchita papa is completely burnt, whereas the agami papa, which will be done by the jnani sharira, there is no sambandha. Why so? Tadvyapadesha. So it's a dvivachana. Uttara purva aghayoho is dvivachana, shashti dvivachana, ashlesha vinashav, respectively. There is no sambandha and vinasha, respectively. So this is also dvivachana. Tad vyapadeshat. Why? Because tayoho vyapadeshat, these have been taught in the shruti. Shrutau vyapadeshat. So sanchita papasya vinashascha, and you can say agami papasya jnaninasa sambandha na bhavati, and sanchita papasya vinashascha bhavati. Why so? Shrutau tad vyapadeshat, tayoho vyapadeshat, or that kind of teaching is there in the shruti. So tad adhigame, what is tad adhigame? Tad adhigame is when adhigama is when understanding takes place. Tasya brahmana adhigame sati. Tad is brahma there. So tasya adhigama is tad adhigamaha. In tasya brahmana adhigamaha is understanding of that Brahma Aikya. Aikya with that Brahma, the way Nirguna Brahma is in my own Swarupa. Sati, Sati Saptami, Tasmin, Tadadigame Sati, Tasya Brahmana Adigame Sati, Jnane Sati. Then when one has become Jnani, then there is Sanchita, Nasha, Papa Nasha, and then there is Agami Papa Sambandha Rahityam. Thereby, there is no binding. But what remains now has to be looked into. Punya remains, and also what? Because Punya is not discussed in this shloka, in this sutra yet. But Prarabdha does remain. So this will be the discussion in the Vritti. We will see the Vritti proper in the next Patha. आम्नायन्ते के समसिद्धम आदि मध्यांत वर्जितम आनंदघन महापूर्ण आत्मज्योतिरुपासमहे नमस्ते धन्यवाद.